Minneapolis. The woman who was with a St. Paul man when he was fatally shot by members of a U.S. Marshals Service task force during an arrest attempt in Minneapolis said through her attorneys Thursday that the law enforcement officers were not in uniform and did not identify themselves as authorities when they surrounded the SUV with their guns drawn. Norhan Askar was on a date with Winston Boogie Smith Jr. and was sitting in an SUV in a Minneapolis parking ramp on June 3 when Smith, who was black, was fatally shot as authorities tried to arrest him on a weapons violation. Authorities have said Smith showed a handgun, and that evidence shows he fired it. Askar's attorneys said previously that she never saw a gun on Smith or in his vehicle. Askar's attorneys reiterated that Thursday, and released additional information in advance of a lawsuit that they say will allege Askar's civil rights were violated. Askar did not appear at a news conference with her attorneys, Christopher Nguyen and Racy Rodney, but they released a statement on her behalf. The attorney said Askar met Smith, 32, through mutual friends and they had been dating for several weeks. They went to a restaurant for lunch and drinks, walked back to Smith's SUV, got inside, and were suddenly surrounded by unmarked cars and people with guns. These people were dressed in neither sheriff nor peace officer uniforms. They yelled commands and did not announce themselves as law enforcement of any kind, the attorney said. While yelling commands for them to put their hands up, multiple armed people targeted their weapons upon her and Mr. Smith. Askar's attorney said that she was scared for her life and complied, and that Smith had a mobile phone and began to record for Facebook Live. As he raised the phone, all she could hear was gunfire and saw Winston Smith slump over, the attorney said. When asked if they were suggesting that law enforcement mistook the phone for a gun, Nguyen said, "I think that's a logical inference." When asked whether task force officers are supposed to identify themselves as law enforcement, a spokesman for the U.S. Marshals Service said he could not comment due to the ongoing investigation. A spokeswoman with the Minnesota Bureau of Criminal Apprehension also had no additional comment, citing the ongoing investigation. The attorney said Askar was pulled out of the SUV, handcuffed and put in the back of an unmarked car. She stayed in handcuffs until paramedics gave her medical attention. The attorney said an officer later asked her how her date was. Askar experienced trauma from seeing Smith killed next to her, and she is still healing from injuries she received when she was sprayed by broken glass, her attorney said. Nguyen said that Askar knew Smith for more than 6 months, and at some point, someone suggested he had a warrant. When she asked him about it, Smith told Askar he had gotten into some trouble but the case had been dismissed.